Sheila Go and Cassandra Ong will remain under the custody of the NBI until formal charges are filed against them. While Go is facing cases related to immigration laws, the Justice Department says Ong will be charged with obstruction of justice. The Senate has already requested the NBI to bring the two to the upper chamber next Tuesday to testify before three Senate panels that will investigate their escape, along with that of dismissed Mayor Alice Koo.
Dito muna sila. Pagkatapos, I think sa Martes merong Senate hearing. Dadali namin sila doon. We are giving all our kakayahan na makuha natin si Mayor Alice.
A Philippine lawmaker wants Cassandra Ong to testify before the House Quad Committee investigating illegal pogos and extrajudicial killings during the Duterte drug war. Let's get more details from our correspondent Willard Cheng. Willard, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Stanley. House Committee on Public Order and Safety Chair Congressman Dan Fernandez believes there is somebody bigger behind Alice Go and Cassandra Ong, hence the need for Ong to testify in the House Quad Committee looking into illegal activities related to pogos and dangerous drugs. The lead chair of the House Quad Committee, Congressman Ace Barber, said the next Quadcom hearing is set on August 28, Wednesday, and that the agenda will still be discussed when asked if Ong would be asked to appear by then.
Sino yung taong behind her? There must be somebody. At hindi kami naniniwala si Cassandra Leong lang yan. There must be somebody much bigger than her na dapat nating malaman. Kasi yung criminal intent, ano? Yung mga nangyari, mga criminal element dun sa Pogo, sa Pora. Eh, hindi ko alam kung kakayanin yan yun. Ni Cassandra Leong. Yung mga torture, pagpatay, pagputol ng mga ulo, yung pag-torture, hindi makakayanan ni Cassandra yon. Sino behind sa kanya? And that's the reason why we want her under our custody.
Ang aming pakiusap, kagaya ng ibang mga witnesses na PDLs, pwede naman namin silang i-request na dalhin sa Kongreso at magbigay ng kanilang mga pahayag. So yun ang aming as of now, as we speak, wala pa kaming information as to ano lang tapos na ba yung processing or hindi pa.
Meanwhile, Barbers justified the detention of former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque for contempt after the committee rejected his reason for his absence in the August 16 Quadcom hearing in Pampanga. Roque had cited the court hearing as an excuse, but a court certification said Roque had no scheduled hearing that day. Roque will be released after spending 24 hours in the house detention facility.
Marami po tayong na-contempt na hindi lamang nagsinungaling kundi nag-violate ng rule. Eh, pagka tayo po hindi naging patas sa ating pagpataw ng penalty sa mga nagkakaroon ng violation dyan sa ating committee, ang ating committee ay hindi na po paniniwalaan at wala pong magre-respeto. Kaya kami po ay nanindigan.
Asked how the committee was able to get hold of two former inmates in Davao who implicated former President Rodrigo Duterte for allegedly ordering the killing of three Chinese nationals in 2016, Barber said it was the PIDEA Director General who approached the committee, expressing there were PDLs who wanted to testify in the Quadcom. The Quadcom, he said, weighed the value of their testimony, as they do with others, to see if these would contribute to efforts in finding out the truth. Barber said Duterte will be given the highest courtesy on how the former president would treat the Quadcom's invitation for him to appear. He again reiterated the Quadcom's probe is not politically motivated and is not a witch hunt, but is after the truth. Back to you, Stanley.
Thank you so much for the update, Willard Cheng.
The Philippine Justice Department defending the arrests of the sister of dismissed Mamban Mayor Alice Go, Sheila, and Cassandra Ong. The two are now under the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation after they were intercepted in Indonesia. Ong's lawyer, attorney Ferdinand Topacio, questioned his client's arrest, saying it should have been done by the House Sergeant at Arms, which has a legislative warrant for her.
she is convinced that she has committed no criminal acts. Even if you are charged with any crime, unless and until there is a case filed in court via an information and a warrant of arrest issued by the court, you cannot be taken in detention by the NBI or the PNP. So, malusot lang po yan. What they are saying yesterday is that she will be charged. There is no information, no warrant of arrest. The only warrant subsisting at this time is the warrant from the House of Representatives.
But the DOJ asserts the arrests are valid.
Kay Sheila, ang pag-aresto sa kanya kagabi ng Bureau of Immigration ay dahil sa paglabag ng Immigration Act, violation of immigration laws. Dahil nga ito na lumalabas talaga na may duda na talaga tayo sa nationality niya at nakasecure siya ng Philippine passport, at bukod dun, lumalabas sa record ng BI na nakalabas siya ng Pilipinas na di dumadaan sa mga port natin. So, illegal exit. So far, no, sa tingin namin, Pilipino tong si Cassandra Ong. Kaya pagdating niya, inaresto siya ng NBI sa paglabag ng mga iba-ibang criminal law, no? Kasama na dyan yung obstruction of justice, yung, ang balita ko, yung violation of Passport Act, at balita ko din yung violation, yung criminal provisions ng Immigration Act.
Authorities believe the two were with Alice Goh in Indonesia. The disgraced former mayor is wanted for her alleged involvement in Pogo Link crimes, as well as for using a fake identity to gain Filipino citizenship. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. calls for improved digitalization efforts at the local level. He spoke Friday at a local government summit, attended by representatives from the World Bank and the International Labor Organization. Marcos extolled LGUs to implement smart solutions to drive growth in society and in local businesses.
In a time when communities and societies have embraced digitalization, there's no excuse for governments, national or local, to allow themselves to be left behind. It is incumbent upon us to promote these smart solutions, such as innovative technologies and strategies, so we can maximize its advantages, especially in the face of challenges that threaten the overall well-being of our constituents.